So, after E3 and EA's show that was nothing short of horrendous, I don't know who put it together. I don't know who the hell they have working there in the PR department that figures, you know what we need? Trevor Noah. He speaks to gamers. And then they have Trevor Noah show you Battlefield 5, and you think, ooh, this is a mess.
Welcome, everyone, to the Battlefield 5 live reveal. I'm your host for this evening, Trevor Noah, and I'm so excited to be here introducing this new edition of Battlefield, which for some reason everyone has already assumed is Battlefield 5. I mean, and not Battlefield V. Could be V. Why not V? Battlefield V could be just as good. Yeah, I do love that fans on Twitter are actually changing the Vs in their profiles for this game, something my mother did many years ago ahead of the curve. And most people don't know this, but the V in my name is actually a 5. Yeah, my name is actually pronounced Trev 5 or Noah. Very unique.
Oh my God! Stop!
Then you get E3 with the unfunny redhead. But then again, as I said before, if you watch most of the E3 press conferences, there was an influx of unfunny women.
That's not all. Call right now and you'll also receive a brand spanking new gameplay trailer for Rage 2.
And what's that number to call?
1-800, I really hadn't thought this far ahead.
Help me! Somebody help me!
After E3, more shit started hitting the fan because EA, for some reason, can't seem to keep their nose clean. EA's a lot like that drunk uncle you got, and his name is Teddy. And Teddy tells you he drives better drunk. So Patrick Sutherland, EA's chief officer of designs, says Battlefield 5 is a game that DICE wanted to make full stop. But if you remember a few weeks back, it was actually one BioWare dev that was touting the need for female characters in Battlefield 5. Now, the problem that most people have here isn't that it's a female character, because female characters are in every fucking game now. Nobody gives a shit. But when you go for something like World War II, I would think it needs to pertain to something more based in reality because these were based on realistic events. And I've seen people sit there and say, oh, well, Battlefield Bad Company 1 and 2 weren't based in reality. No fucking shit, Sherlock. Really? Battlefield 3 and 4 weren't based in reality. No shit. We didn't go to war with China a few years ago. Well, I'll be damned. I bet next you're going to tell me 2041 Battlefield wasn't based in reality either. Holy fuck. I'm pretty sure someone's going to just shatter my illusion of the world and tell me Superman isn't real.
Not real Superman. But what women do every day is nothing short of super.
No fucking shit. But the thing is, World War II did happen. You fucking fucknut, go fuck yourself. My God. People who don't like the women in the Battlefield trailer didn't pay attention to history. Fuck you, bitch.
It's all in the Battlefield 5 trailer. For a start, none of the women that she mentions in the article are actually British. The closest you can get is Nancy Wake, who was actually from New Zealand and actually was living in France when the war broke out, which is why she ended up joining the French Resistance and the SOE. While it's clear that she did fight a very successful guerrilla warfare campaign against the Germans, it should be noted that she was not actually part of the regular military, and therefore was not actually operating on the front lines but behind enemy lines. It's still definitely an interesting story, and it's one that probably should be looked at, but it wouldn't be anything at all like the gameplay footage from the trailer that we saw from DICE. In the case of the Night Witches, along with the Russian sniper, well, they're both Russian and therefore fought on the Eastern Front. And granted, the Eastern Front is definitely something that should be looked at when talking about a World War II game, but the Russians, of course, did not fight for the British Army either. In the case of Wanda Gertz, she of course fought for Poland, or more specifically the Polish Resistance during World War II. Granted, she was a professional soldier during World War I, however, she was not technically a professional soldier in World War II. She was part of the Resistance movement. The same is of course also true with the female battalion that she formed, and it should also be noted that she fought on the Eastern Front and not on the Western Front, which is where the game's trailer took place.
Yeah, The Verge. Megan something or other. Go fuck yourself. Alright, you're gonna sit here, show me this Battlefield 5 trailer, where everybody there looks like a rejected member from Captain Fucking Planet.
Fire! Wind! Water!
When your annoyance is combined, I am social justice! And they're led by a ginger British woman who has a prosthetic hook hand. And don't you dare give me no shit about prosthetic limbs work really well. Let me see someone with a prosthetic limb from back then fire off a weapon. Fuck off. We're sitting here pretending Battlefield 5, based in World War II, was Cyberpunk 2077, where all of a sudden prosthetic limbs are fully functional and completely capable. Get out of here. Prosthetic limbs were garbage then, and they're just getting better now. It only took damn near 100 years. Have you seen plastic surgery from World War II? If you got disfigured in World War I or II, guess what they did for you for plastic surgery? They made you look like the Elephant Man and then gave you a goddamn mask so you could also look like the Phantom of the fucking Opera. And we're sitting here pretending, oh, a prosthetic limb was perfectly capable of functioning in World War II. Eat me. Shit, the military don't take you now if you're flat-footed and got asthma. And we're pretending in 1942, a prosthetic limb. Oh my God, fuck you. Jesus Christ. It reminds me of the term, woke but not awake. It's ridiculous. Let me move on. So anyway, you know, this dev from DICE wrote some bullshit here. I know this is going to be a fight when I push for female soldiers in Battlefront. I have a daughter and I don't want ever to have to answer her question, why can't I make a female character that looks like me, with because you're a girl. I fundamentally feel to my core this is right. Wait, how is your fucking daughter gonna handle fucking school, asshole? She's gonna go to school, they're gonna talk about World War II, and what's she gonna do? Stand up and go, where are all the female soldiers? I hate Saving Private Ryan. There were women in war. My daddy made fucking Battlefront 5. He knows these things. Fuck you. This is gender phobic or whatever the fuck the kids say today that makes no goddamn sense because they have no real problems. You know why everybody is the way they are today? Because not enough people caught an ass whooping. A good old fashioned passionate ass whooping where you got your shoes, coat, your hat taken. Those were the days when you were too busy worrying about actually getting your ass beaten, robbed, shot or stabbed, or your family whooping your ass for failing class. You were too busy living in reality to have some fucking opinions that made no damn sense. And don't get me wrong, also, like, there's a black guy in the front lines wearing goddamn paint from Bali on his face. It's just ridiculous. It's not about fucking historical accuracy whatsoever. This is about selling microtransactions.
And you will now be able to customize your soldiers, your vehicles, and your weapons, not only for the gameplay, but for the looks, as part of our portrayal of the Second World War.
And EA sitting there going, all right, if we cater to the Anita Sarkeesians and the Zoe Quinns of the world, they'll defend us, we'll look like heroes or something. They're pretending like female characters in a game is the right side of history, like it never happened before. Nobody's complaining about Call of Duty with female characters. Do you know why? Because Black Ops isn't based in fucking reality. If you wanted to make a game that had female characters with prosthetic limbs, then you should have did 2041, you fucking assholes. Normally, I don't give a shit, but it's the fact that they keep putting it in our faces, trying to make us seem like we're Philistines. Philistines, however you want to pronounce it. Tomato, tomato. And yes, it does make my nature quite bellicose. I'm actually pissed off by this because it's just so condescending. It's just like when Trump won the election and that, I don't know, you guys probably didn't see it, but on Twitter, some fucking director, some TV show you probably never heard of, saw, or gave a shit about, I'm in the same boat as you, wrote his daughter a letter apologizing for men in America because Trump won the presidency. And I'm like, what the fuck are you doing? You're gonna have your daughter growing up with a complex where she believes men should apologize for just existing. If I could teleport to your house and slap you in the face a few times and tell you to act like a goddamn man, and your daughter got her first taste of the world, guess what? Nothing's fucking fair. Were you gonna write her a letter for watching History Channel? You know, when a lion kills like a baby gazelle or something, and she starts crying, you're gonna go run into your damn office, pick up a pen and paper? I'd like to apologize for the lion killing the baby gazelle and making you cry. Because lions eat little baby gazelles and it's a horrible world we live in and Trump is president and Hillary should have won. I'm crying tears of scarlet for you, my sweet baby girl. Fuck you. God, what the hell happened to men? What happened to the damn world? See, I'm way off point. Now I'm just pissed. I'm pissed for no fucking reason reading this stupid shit. Isn't Patrick Sullivan that fucking evil looking son of a bitch from EA? I bet you it is. I knew it. I knew. Boo. Oh, motherfucker. Let's move on. I'm sorry about this. I haven't had my breakfast. This is something that the development team pushed for, i.e. one douchebag who doesn't have a dick. He has an oversized clit. Sutherland told Gamatsu during the E3 interview, Battlefield 5 is a lot about the unseen, the untold, and the unplayed. The common perception is that there were no women in World War II. There were a ton of women who fought in World War II and partook in the war. Yeah, and they weren't British or American. You know, if they focused on something Russian, it would have made sense. Didn't the Russians have a female tank division and a female sniper division? But that's like scouts. They're still not front line. But point being, Russia did that because they were throwing bodies at the Nazis. They were throwing bodies. Like, Stalin introduced a policy called the no one step back policy. If you were fighting and they thought you were retreating, they would kill you on the spot, and then your family would be incarcerated.
In 1942, the German army had finally met its match. In the single greatest battle in history, the Soviets had lost more men than the British and the Americans in the entire war. An estimated 500,000 men were killed. The Germans had lost at least 200,000 of their best troops, but likely far more. The civilian dead is unknown. The Germans could destroy Stalingrad, but they could never take it. Under Stalin's strict orders, anyone retreating or surrendering was to be treated as a traitor, his family subject to imprisonment. It was Stalin's feared not one step back policy. In Stalingrad, more than 13,000 Soviet soldiers were shot by their own side. Over the course of the war, over 135,000 were killed in this manner. 400,000 served in punishment battalions. In that year, there were still over 4 million prisoners in the gulags. Nonetheless, with motives ranging from patriotism to terror, the Soviet soldiers, with their backs against the Volga River, fought from street corner to street corner in that cruelest of winters. By January 1943, the end finally came when General von Paulus surrendered the remainder of his 6th Army. He started with over 300,000 men, and over 91,000 had surrendered, with whom approximately only 9,000 returned alive after the war to Germany. Hitler is have said to have lamented,
"Der Gott des Krieges ist zu der anderen Seite übergangen."
The whole legend of Nazi invincibility had been shattered. German armies could retreat too. German armies could be defeated. German troops could be captured. Throughout these pivotal years, the Soviets were regularly battling over 200 German divisions. In contrast, the Americans and British, fighting over the Mediterranean, rarely confronted more than 10 German divisions. Germany had lost over 6 million men fighting the Soviets, and approximately 1 million fighting on the Western Front. Though the myth lives on that the United States won World War II, serious historians agree that it was the Soviet Union and its entire society, including its brutal dictator, Joseph Stalin, through sheer desperation and incredibly stoic heroism, forged the great narrative of World War II. The defeat of the monster German war machine.
Stalin didn't even let his own son. You know, his son got caught, and Stalin left him for dead. He wasn't fucking around. The Russians pretty much fought World War II for the entire world before the Americans and the British came in, did a little salt and pepper, a little mustard and jam, helped out a bit. And then everybody pretends like America won World War II for some goddamn reason. I mean, it's fucking brutal. Stalin even got people from the gulag and had them fighting. Was it the gulag? I can't remember the camp he used to have where, like, prisoners were at. And then he was like, all right, you can get out and fight for Russia. It's, like, ridiculous. On top of that, there was no integration in the American fucking forces. I'm pretty goddamn sure. Even the Native Americans that helped out in World War II were segregated to each other and were called the Code Talkers. Because there are so few goddamn Native Americans, they could send codes to each other through radio waves. And the Japanese were kind of like, what the fuck is this? This isn't English. What language is this? Because damn near Native Americans almost completely died out because of America killing them. And you got the black guy up in the mix. That don't make no sense. Segregation was crazy going on during World War II. While America was fighting the Nazis, they were also fighting black people in the streets.
Today, few remember that the Second World War saw more strikes than any other time period in American history. In 1944 alone, 1 million U.S. workers were on strike at one time or another. The war had rejuvenated American capitalism. Corporate profits rose from $6.4 billion in 1940 to $10.8 billion in 1944. Put simply, war was good business, but in the face of rising corporate profits, workers' wages were frozen. As a result, a wave of strikes rocked the nation. Americans versus Americans, a tragic spectacle in these critical times, when unity is essential to the preservation of democracy. Detroit was a key city in Roosevelt's arsenal of democracy. Many African American families migrated north in search of work in the many armament factories. Racial tensions soon escalated. One demonstrator jeered,
"I'd rather see Hitler and Hirohito win than work beside a nigger on the assembly line."
In June, violence exploded, exacerbated by the city's nearly all-white police force. Federal troops arrived to restore order with live ammunition. 34 were killed in the riots, 25 of them black. Henry Wallace went to Detroit to survey the damage. He was appalled.
"We cannot fight to crush not so brutality abroad and condone race riots at home."
Years later, these sentiments would be echoed by Dr. Martin Luther King in reference to the Vietnam War.
And we're sitting here just rewriting history, turning into this inclusive bullshit. Fuck you, Sutherland. Fuck DICE. Fuck EA. I can't wait for you motherfuckers to burn for sucking. And I'm just saying this out of anger because of the way they're portraying history. You know, we can't look at history and paint it with rose-tinted glasses. It should be realistic. They could have actually done something here that would have made sense. They could have shown the brutality of war. They could have shown how Russia fought the war, how Stalin forced his people to give up their lives. Did you know that they were even eating each other? The Nazis tried to take what capital city? I can't remember, and it's driving me mad. But the Nazis are trying to take it, and was it Stalingrad or something? I can't remember, so I'm gonna fucking just skip it, forgive me. But they were trying to take it, and the Russians would not give it to them. And there were even Russians who stayed in the city while it was being bombarded by the Nazis. And some of them played music while the whole war went on. And there was a whole serious famine going on. People were eating rats. People were like eating the glue from drywall that they turned into soup. There was cannibalism going on. That's how brutal it was for the Russians. They could have did something like that, really taught you something, scared the shit out of you. They could have showed you the segregation, all this sort of fucked up shit that went, "Nah, we're not gonna do that. We're gonna give you customization. You could be anything you want." This is why nobody knows shit about history, because we focus on the wrong shit. Yes, there were female soldiers, but usually, if it was a woman on the front lines, she was part of the resistance. Once again, a lot of Russians.
Behind German lines, Russian, Ukrainian, and Belarusian partisans were attacking from forests and caves, blowing up trains, interfering with transportation, and in any way possible, tampering with the German war machine and engaging up to 10% of the German occupation forces. The partisans became an indispensable factor in the ultimate victory of the Soviet troops. But the consequences were devastating, the Germans behaving with more and more terrorism, hanging partisans and innocents alike. No one knows how many, but estimates range from 4 to 8 million Ukrainians killed in the war, and it is estimated that Belarusia lost a quarter of its population, at least 2.5 million dead. Approximately 200 cities and 9,000 villages were burned to the ground. It is estimated that at least 100,000 partisans were killed or missing.
Time you saw black and white guys fighting together against the Nazis was the Abraham Lincoln Brigade when they were helping out the Spanish versus, I can't even remember who was in power at the time. Oh my God.
Mexico Oil Company, headed by a pro-fascist, promised Franco all the oil he needed on credit. Roosevelt was furious and threatened an oil embargo and slapped Texaco with a fine. But Texaco persisted, undeterred, and also supplied oil to Hitler. The fighting dragged on for 3 years. Some 2,800 brave Americans snuck into Spain to battle the fascists, most joining the communist-backed Abraham Lincoln Brigade. Almost 1,000 did not return.
Tell us, Inglés, why have you come so far to fight for our republic?
A man fights for what he believes in, Fernando.
Well, but in his own country.
Well, maybe you feel that I'm sticking my nose into other people's business. But I don't feel that way. It's not only Spain fighting here, is it? It's Germany and Italy on one side and Russia on the other, and the Spanish people right in the middle of it all. The Nazis and fascists are just as much against democracy as they are against the communists. And they're using your country as a proving ground for their new war machinery, their tanks and dive bombers and stuff like that, so they can get the jump on the democracies and knock off England and France and my country before we get armed and ready to fight.
But Franco triumphed, and the Republic fell in the spring of 1939, bearing with it not only over 100,000 Republican soldiers and 5,000 foreign volunteers, but the hopes and dreams of many progressives. By 1939, Roosevelt told his cabinet that his policies in Spain had been a grave mistake and warned that they all soon would pay the price.
I'll just like cut in clips if I could find it. You know, they could have did a story around that. But no, we're just going to do something totally else and go fuck them. Sutherland then said, I have a 13-year-old daughter that when the trailer came out and she saw the flak, she asked me, Dad, why is this happening? He continued, she plays Fortnite and says, I could be a girl in Fortnite. Why are people upset about this? Because Fortnite isn't real and it wasn't based in World War II. And then Patrick Sullivan probably says something smart as fuck that deserves to get him slapped in the face. I just said, you know what? You're right. It's not okay. These are the people who are uneducated. They don't understand that this is a plausible scenario. Go suck a dick, Sutherland. You look like you do. It's a plausible scenario. It's a fucking cripple woman in World War II is 360 no-scoping or 180 no-scope. Plausible scenario. She lost her arm, but somehow that really advanced 1930s and 40s technology just came through and made her a killing machine. The bitch was the Terminator. It's totally plausible. Listen, this is a game, and today gaming is gender diversive, like it hasn't been before. Many females are on the mobile. Once again, fuck you, Sutherland. There are a lot of female people who want to play, and male players who want to play as a badass woman. And we don't take any flack. We stand up for the cause. Because I think these people who don't understand it, well, you have two choices. Either accept it or don't buy the game. I'm fine with either. Or, it's just not okay. If I was a bird, I'd shit on Sutherland. Like, if I had a superpower, I would turn into a bald eagle at will and just shit on people who deserve to be shit on. So basically, you know, once again, it's the usual. As I said before in a previous video, don't go to Reddit. It's Battlefield 5 thing, posting anything that's historically accurate. If you point out that a woman with a prosthetic limb that helped train French soldiers had a tough time even walking behind, you know, Nazi lines, you will be banned. If you dare show up with any information that refutes the fact that women are super strong, especially crippled women during the 1930s, you will be banned for being a misogynist. And on that note, fuck all of this. It's ridiculous. I'm just pissed off at the way they're portraying it. Just trying to make you feel like you're an asshole. Oh, you're uneducated. Suck my fucking dick. Every one of the female snipers they talked about that did something wasn't American or British. You're uneducated and you're a fucking asshat. I saw a video of a guy with a prosthetic leg just trying to jog down the street. It's the saddest shit I ever saw. And you want me to believe, and that video is from a dude in the 1970s or 80s, and you want me to believe prosthetic limbs from 40 years beyond that were all of a sudden better than what he had in the 80s. Get the fuck out of here. I'm sorry, I'm leaving now. This video is far too long. I wanted it to be like 5 minutes tops, and then I just flew off the goddamn handle. I apologize to those who wanted better information from me. I will cut in some stuff that makes more sense. While I was editing this, it reoccurred to me. There was a whole fallout with Battlefield 1 on Twitter, where they put up a couple really stupid fucking tweets that were meant to, I don't know, engage the average person or a broader audience. They had tweets such as, "Your squad got big plans for the weekend? Hashtag just World War One things. Ha 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 ha. When your squad is looking on point." The next one, which is the one that really got them in trouble, "Weekend goals. Hashtag just World War One things. When you're too hot for the club." Oots! Ow, sizzling girl. "Do you have a fire extinguisher? Because my pussy's on fire." After being called out for putting out some really stupid tweets like that, Battlefield then apologized. "We apologize for any offense taken in the content posted earlier. It was not at all our intention to show any lack of respect for the World War One era." And here we are again in World War II, baby. Yum yum. Microtransactions. Go fuck yourself, EA.